Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com. Lakers Grizzlies tonight. Just want to give everybody a quick update on the injury report, how things are looking on that front, LeBron, AD, all of that sort of stuff. Plus, get into the matchup a little bit and what we really need to see happen for the Lakers tonight, both in this game and around the NBA. So welcome in, everybody. Glad to see you here in this format. If you're joining this show live, you're seeing this over on the Shorts platform. If you're not live watching this, then you're seeing it on the live feed. Interesting the way YouTube breaks that up. But in any event, welcome in, everybody. Let's talk a little bit about the injury report right now. LeBron James, questionable for tonight's game against the Grizzlies. You know, it wouldn't necessarily shock me if LeBron were to not play. I mean, we kind of saw the Warriors employ this tactic last night when they took on a really bad Blazers team. What they wound up doing was they rested Klay Thompson, rested Draymond Green in order to have them ready for tonight against the New Orleans Pelicans, which doesn't bode well for the Lakers because they just barely escaped with a win against the Blazers last night. Anyway, could the Lakers do the same thing tonight with LeBron, not play him against a pretty bad Grizzlies side, and then have him as fresh as possible for Sunday's big matchup with the Pelicans? Maybe. I tend to think LeBron's going to play. He'll be in this one. They're not going to rest him with a day in between. The Lakers have tomorrow off before they have to play New Orleans. From Memphis to New Orleans, it's not that far of a trip. I would imagine he'd play, just throwing out the idea that potentially, the Lakers could consider employing that strategy that we saw the Warriors use last night. Now, Anthony Davis, great news. Was that shoot around, said he feels phenomenal. This was from Dan Wojcicki of the LA Times, said that he feels phenomenal. And that was great to hear. So that means AD, he's listed as probable. He's playing tonight. AD is going to play in this one. That's great news for the Lakers. Right now, the Lakers still very heavy favorites over the Grizzlies. Last I looked, it was 15.5 points. That's massive. That also suggests, because those lines, they tend to know when somebody's not going to play. That would also suggest that LeBron is probably going to be a go as well for this one. So LeBron probably going to play, but still listed as questionable. Maybe we see some shenanigans with that tonight. Anthony Davis, he's a go. Jared Vanderbilt still out. No word on him. Hopefully we'll hear something else maybe later tonight or something on where he's at in his recovery. Other than that, though, of course, no Christian Wood as well. No Jalen Huccifino. Everybody else, though, is a go for this game. That means Gabe Vincent will be out there for them. Cam Reddish will be available and all of that. Now, the Grizzlies have benched for the season Desmond Bane, Jaren Jackson Jr. They've shut those guys down. However, Memphis still plays very, very hard. This is a team that competes every single night. They will make the Lakers work. If the Lakers think that all they have to do is just show up and they're automatically given a win, that's probably not going to be the case. That's probably not going to be the case. They have to make sure that they go out there and they perform in this game. So the Lakers, business-like attitude for this one. There's no way they should drop this game, especially given it's an insanely depleted Memphis team. No Ja Morant, no Jaren Jackson, no Desmond Bane playing for them. There's others too, but they're going to be missing a number of players. So the Lakers, they need to get out there, take care of business, let talent win out. They are by far the more talented group, but they have to win this game. Now, the other things that we have to see happen around the NBA, the big one. The Pelicans are taking on the Warriors. Right now, the Warriors are a favorite to win in that one. Last I looked, it was a 4.5-point favorite. What we want to see is that not come to pass. We want to see the Pelicans beat the Warriors, not the other way around. The Warriors are the favorite. They rested Klay. They rested Draymond last night, so they'd be ready for tonight's game. It's in Golden State. All of that is not ideal from the Lakers' side of things. But the Pelicans beating the Warriors, that alone happening, if that's the only thing that goes the Lakers' way tonight, aside from the Lakers winning, then the Lakers have a path to back to the ninth seed. All you need is a Warriors loss, and the Lakers control their own destiny in terms of getting to the ninth seed. I know that's not what people want, is just to be the ninth seed, but to move up out of 10 at least means the first game of the play-in tournament would be held at home rather than on the road, which that can definitely matter. So that's the most important thing. The Pelicans need to beat the Warriors tonight. Again, the Warriors are the favorites. We need the Pelicans to pull off the upset. Also of note, Brandon Ingram, he's coming back. Win the Lakers, but not tonight. Of course not. When the Lakers play the Pelicans, he's coming back. He's returning on Sunday. Of course. So that's the first thing. The other thing that we want to see happen to make this as easy as possible would be a Suns win against the Sacramento Kings. That's what we want to see happen. If those two things happen, the Suns beat the Kings, the Pelicans beat the Warriors, there is a path for the Lakers to get the 8th seed at that point. Now, are there other ways that they can get there? Sure, like if the Suns were to lose to the Kings tonight, and then the Kings lose in their final game, I want to say it's against Portland, and the Suns lose to Minnesota, that gives the Lakers a chance to move up. If the Lakers wind up tied with the Suns, they do have the tiebreaker there. However, I've been saying it for a while, any tiebreaker situation that includes Sacramento is poison for the Lakers. It's so bad because they are 0-4 against the Kings. If they're in a three-way tie, if the Kings are involved, the Lakers almost always wind up going straight to the bottom of that group. So you don't want to end up tied with Sacramento. You also can't end up tied with the Golden State Warriors. Right now, that's exactly what they are. They're tied with both those teams. The Lakers are the bottom of that group because they don't have the tiebreaker over either. So really important that the Warriors, the Kings, they do not wind up tied with the Lakers. We need both of those teams to take at least one more loss before the season ends. That's what needs to happen for the Lakers in order for them to move up. And again, ideally, the way it will happen is a Kings and Warriors loss tonight. You can still wind up moving up if you wind up tied with the Suns and the Warriors drop or the Kings drop their game at the end of the season. Maybe something like that can happen. There's other things that can happen, but the cleanest path to making it happen would be those two teams losing, and then we know what you're playing for on Sunday. We know exactly what's on the line on Sunday. It would be win, and you are at least the 8th seed on Sunday, and that would be fantastic. That could set up a massive game, which could even send the Pelicans back a little bit too, should they not win. They'll have reason to try to win that game. All right, all of that gets crazy. My brain is fried at this point from like weeks now of monitoring the standings and trying to figure out who can go where and what a win does for each team and all of that kind of stuff. Bottom line, Lakers need to win their games. Got to win tonight against Memphis. Got to win Sunday against New Orleans. No guarantee that's even enough to move them out of the 10 seed at this point, unfortunately. But all the Lakers can do right now is win their games and then let the chips fall where they may. All right, everybody. Thank you guys for joining me here. I'm checking out some of your comments in the chat here. Fab says, if we make the 8 seed. By the way, if you're joining me live right now, sometimes the shorts platform, you see some new people coming in. If you haven't subscribed yet, subscribe to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. I'm going to keep you up to date with everything about the playoffs, everything about the offseason, everything that's going to be going on with this team in terms of free agency, trades, all that kind of stuff, the draft, of course. So make sure you subscribe to the channel. But let's see. Fab says, I think we'll make the 8th seed, but I don't see us getting past the first round, even if we make the playoffs. Silver lining, if the Clippers lose to Mavs in round one, Ty Lue comes to us next year. Well, I don't know. If I'm the Clippers, I wouldn't be eager to part with Ty Lue, but maybe they make the mistake and the Lakers can step in and right that wrong, because the Lakers made the mistake that allowed Ty Lue to get to the Clippers to begin with when they didn't give him the kind of deal that he should have got. But I don't see the Clippers getting rid of Ty Lue. I would not mind the Clippers going home in round one. That would certainly be what I'd be cheering for. As far as the Lakers going home in round one, I think that's part of why they really need to get up to the 7 or 8 seed if possible. Again, it may not be possible, but if they can right now, that would give them Minnesota in round one instead of Denver. If they can get to the 7 or 8 seed, win the first game, that would put them into the 7 seed heading into the playoffs, which would mean they would get Minnesota in round one if things stay as they are currently, which it's no guarantee, but things stay where they are right now. They will get Minnesota in round one, which I would prefer to having to see Denver, though Minnesota is a very good team as well. If the Lakers stay in the 9-10 matchup, the best they can possibly do is the 8th seed, and that would get them a first-round matchup as of right now. Again, things can change, but as of right now, with Denver, which is obviously a rough draw for a Lakers team that hasn't beat Denver in the last 8 tries. All right. Everybody, Sky Falcon, we don't have the luxury to choose who we play, unfortunately. No, we can hope for the best. But at this point for the Lakers, just win. Just win your games. Do everything you can to get in. See where the chips fall. Maybe you're the 9, maybe you're the 10, maybe you're the 8 seed. We don't know. But you just got to win. That's all. You have to win games, period. That's it. All right, everybody, again, thank you so much for joining here on the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Again, if you're not a subscriber, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Let's get that win tonight against the Grizzlies. Till next time, everybody. See ya and stay safe.